leads into the Sovereign's Entrance. There will be an immediate fanfare. The immediate signs that the Queen has arrived at the Palace of Westminster will be seen above the Victoria Tower, where the Union flag will soon be replaced. It'll be taken down and replaced with the Royal Standard. And that'll take place in just a few moments' time, and then the world will know that the Queen is inside the Palace of Westminster, one of the royal palaces, of course. And there's been a royal palace, the site of the Palace of Westminster, for around 1,000 years. As I mentioned earlier, the oldest part of the palace, which survived the Great Fire back in 1834, is Westminster Hall, which is one of the great spaces of the palace itself. So the Royal Standard now flying, and inside the Royal Gallery, we have the doors of the robing room there, just to the left of the porch as we look at it, and we have the Earl Marshal, the Duke of Norfolk, the man there on the right, who will be ready for the Queen's arrival in just a few moments, because the Queen's very wisely taking a rather quicker route up to the Norman porch and not using the staircase. Her Majesty being greeted by the Marquess of Chamberlain and by the Earl Marshal, and being led into the robing room itself, where Her Majesty will get ready for the state procession into the House of Lords. Ladies in waiting following. And while this is going on, lots of activity going on in the rest of the palace. For example, if we go down to the side of the House of Commons, we will have our first sight of the day of the Speaker, who will be making his way as well. And there we have the Inspector of Police waiting for the Speaker's procession through the central lobbies, the daily occurrence in the Palace of Westminster. Just the announcement that the Speaker's procession is on its way, while we're also seeing the Prince of Wales and the Duchess of Cornwall making their way into the robing room. And at some point, of course, in the future, at some point, Prince of Wales himself will be there as monarch, ready for
the state of...
Hats off, strangers, is the command from the Metropolitan Police officer, Mace bearer, and then the Speaker, John Bercow, who's played such a prominent and, it's fair to say, controversial role in the political process of the last few years. He's making his way down through the members' lobby of the House of Commons into the chamber of the House of Commons itself, where there will be the usual daily prayers of the Speaker's chaplain. No one in any doubt that the Speaker is approaching after all of those shouts. Some members of the Commons there lining the way with officers of the parliamentary staff too. And Winston Churchill there on the left and David Lloyd George on the right, the two great Prime Ministers flanking the entrance to the House of Commons. Mr. Speaker approaches the chair.